Why a group of Australian women are suing Qatar for 2020 strip search at Doha Airport. The Gulf state launched an investigation and an unspecified number of airport security staff were charged, but the woman lawyer Damian Sturjaker said not enough has been done. A group of seven Australian women are suing the government of Qatar after they were forced to undergo an invasive medical examination at the Doha International Airport, their lawyer confirmed Tuesday. The incident occurred on October 2 last year when the women were ordered off flight and strip searched by nurses in an ambulance on the tarmac. The women said they were not asked for permission nor were they told why they were undergoing the searches. The incident described by the women as a state-sponsored assault sparked widespread outrage. At the time, Qatar's Prime Minister Khalid bin Khalifa bin Abdulaziz Al Thani apologized, saying, "We regret the unacceptable treatment of the female passengers. What took place does not reflect Qatar's laws or values." The Gulf state launched an investigation and an unspecified number of airport security staff were charged. But the woman's lawyers, Damian Sturjaker, said not enough has been done. Why were the women made to undergo the medical examination? The strip searches were conducted after the airport authorities found a newborn baby wrapped in a plastic bag near a trash can in a bathroom at Hamad International Airport, the government said at the time. 18 women were taken from different planes, including 2 British women and 13 from Australia, for strip searches after the baby was discovered, but not all the women were ultimately examined. The women were taken off the plane by armed Qatari authorities and subjected to invasive gynecological examinations in ambulances on the airport tarmac to determine whether they were the mother of the baby. I was certain that I was either going to be killed by one of the many men that had a gun or that my husband on the plane was going to be killed, one of the women said in a statement from her lawyer, according to the BBC. How did the Qatar government respond to the incident? Following widespread outrage, Qatar's government apologized for the incident and said the baby was safe. The government said that the baby girl had been found wrapped in a plastic bag buried under trash, which led to an immediate search for the parents, including on flights in the vicinity of where the newborn was found. While the aim of the urgently decided search was to prevent the perpetrators of the horrible crime from accepting the state of Qatar's regrets any distress or infringement on the personal freedom of any traveler caused by this action, the government said in a statement. The incident was denounced around the world, with Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison calling it appalling and unacceptable. The government then called for a comprehensive, transparent investigation into the incident following a criminal prosecution. One airport staff member was arrested. But the woman's lawyer pointed out that the results of the investigation were not published, CNN reported. Nothing has been done, the lawyer Sturjaker said. Why are the women filing a lawsuit against Qatar now? The women, who are all between the ages of 30 and 50, said they had suffered recurring mental health issues after the incident, including post-traumatic stress disorder. According to Sturjaker, some of the women developed a fear of flying, had to take time off from work and seek physiological counseling. They were now seeking an apology from Qatari authorities and are also calling for an open dialogue to ensure incidents like this never happen again. The women are seeking damages, the lawyer said, adding that a suit will be filed within the next few weeks in the New South Wales Supreme Court in Sydney. What is the legality of strip searches? There are no universal laws as far as invasive examinations at airports are concerned. Given that it can be intrusive, particularly when it comes to security personnel inspecting body cavities, it mostly requires legal authority. In this case, the lawsuit states that if the incident had taken place in Australia, it would have amounted to assault and battery. In Northern America, civil lawsuits in such cases have usually been successful, particularly when the search was conducted by someone by the of the opposite sex. One of the more lasting effects of the terrorist attacks on September 11, 2001, commonly referred to as 9/11, that killed 2,977 Americans, was increased security and reduced privacy at airports around the world. Before this, security screening did exist, but it was far less intrusive. Notably, months after the attacks, former US President George W. Bush signed legislation creating the Transportation Security Administration Federal Airport Screeners, who replaced the private companies that were previously responsible for airport security. The law required that all checked bags be screened, cockpit doors be reinforced, and more federal air marshals be put on flights, according to an AP report. As per strip search laws in Australia, New South Wales, this invasion